All right, well, you've seen the title, so let's just get straight into it, yeah? Now, Chicken Stew is the very first song in the album, and it's a decent way to start it off. It's a really weird song, it's got a kinda catchy beat. Overall, it's not that bad. 5 out of 10. Inner Vision is the second song in the album. Solid beat, very melodic lyrics. Just an overall really, really hard-hitting solid song. 7 out of 10. Bubbles is a pretty catchy, but not that great song. It's alright though, pretty good to listen to whenever you just want to listen to something. 6 out of 10. Boom is by far one of the best songs in the song. I meant album. Now, Boom is protesting the government's expenses and how they prioritize the military above anything else, like what they're supposed to be fighting for. Therefore, it protests war, and it has a very good chorus. It just hits well. 8 out of 10. Now, moving on to side B of this first vinyl of the album, because yes, I did buy this album on vinyl like a nerd. New Guns, one of the most melodic songs out of the entire album. Very good, has some questionable lyrics. But overall, it works. It just works. It just works. 8 out of 10. The next song is ADD, which is by far one of my favorite songs out of the entire album because it's protesting how the US mainly focuses on what it wants rather than what it's supposed to be fighting for whenever it goes into war. It's got some very slow, calmer lyrics, and then it leads into a quicker, way heavier chorus, which just fits perfectly. 8 out of 10. Mr. Jack, is that the trick of your disguise? Hey, Mr. Jack. Mr. Jack is also another one of those songs that's really good to me. I don't understand why. It's also because of the musical change. 9 out of 10. IEAIAIO is one of the weirdest songs in the album. Actually, the weirdest song in the album. But it somehow found a way to make very fast, chaotic lyrics with a slower but more melodic chorus work perfectly. It's not one of my favorites, like top two or something, but it's definitely a really good, solid song. 7 out of 10. So, the very first song on this side is 36, which is by far the worst song in the entire album. It's only 47 seconds long, so it doesn't have much room to be a song. And therefore, it fails in just about everything. Which is kind of weird, because System of a Down revels in making very good songs that are under 3 minutes. Most of their songs are under 3 minutes. They're very short, but somehow they're really good. But 36 just fails at that, because it's not long enough. It's got a pretty good guitar bit at the beginning, but it's extremely underused. What with the annoying chorus. And how they barely use that guitar part, it's just not a great song. 3 out of 10. Pictures. It falls under the same category as 36. It's not nearly as bad. It's way longer. I say way longer. More like about 3 minutes. But it just doesn't work. The chorus isn't that great. The lyrics aren't that great. Therefore, about a 4 out of 10. Highway Song is one of my favorite songs in the entire album. I don't understand why. It's just so good. It's a nonsensical but very good song, and what I like most is the music change. I don't know why, it's just so good to me. 9 out of 10. F the System, another pretty good song. It's pretty good to listen to. Wouldn't be in my top like 3 or something, but it's decent. It's got a pretty fast, chaotic lyric sequence, just like some of the other songs I've mentioned. And it's got a fairly medella chorus. It's a lot heavier than some of the other songs. Therefore, I give it a 7 out of 10. Ego Brain, by far my favorite song out of this entire album. It just works perfectly. It's got the slow, calm beginning, and then it just transitions into a very hard-hitting chorus. It just works perfectly. 10 out of 10, best song out of the album. Moving on to the last side of the album, we finally get to the last three. Now, first we have Detail Waves, Zeta Waves, something. I don't even know what it means. Now, not gonna lie, most of the lyrics in the song pretty good, but the chorus just doesn't fit because the preset fast beat that's already been put there and the fast lyrics just doesn't fit with the very slow chorus that they put in. Therefore, it's just not that great. Now, near the end, it fits decently, but it's just not that great. 6 out of 10. Now, next we get to Roulette, which is one of the better songs in the album, I'd say myself. And it just works. It's a slow, calm song, a break from everything else. 7 out of 10. Streamline, the very last song in the album, with a 6-8 measure time. Very weird to put in an album like that. A very weird measure time, just 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3. But it works, somehow. They make the weirdest things work, okay? It's pretty good. I mean, the chorus is kind of annoying, but near the end it works perfectly. A good way to seal off the album. 7 out of 10. Now, with all that being said, if I were to rank this out of all 5 of the albums, I personally would probably put it in first. I mean, it sounds weird. It has some songs that I dislike, but the songs that I do like are very good. So, for now, it's going to be in my first place out of all 5 of the albums. I'll be reviewing the others later on, other albums. I just figured I should take a break from all the other type of videos that I'm doing and do an album review instead, you know? Seems like a decent idea, why not? So, with that said, I'm gonna go ahead and end off the video here.